doesn't want to be on this fucking bus. But here I am. My calendar is sending me notification after notification. It's screaming deadline tomorrow. But I'm out. I'm wearing way too much clothes and I'm heading to prison.
Oh, my nipples are freezing. I'm in the coat the size of Alaska and... Did I need to have my legs out this evening? Guess not, but it's prison. And all the girls there are going to have theirs out.
I've got my iPhone. I'm just trying to drain out all these thoughts.
Don't be stupid. He'll be too drunk to notice you.
I'll get in. I'm not even going to be able to find him.
He'll be with some girl.
Fucked off his face.
He'll stay for an hour.
Maybe two.
Get hit on by a creep and be too tired not to flirt back.
Then go home at midnight, grab himself a subway.
Oh, I shouldn't be doing this.
I've got so much work to be doing.
I told myself not to get involved.
He's not even going to care.
I'm the one hurting myself here.
What the fuck am I doing?
I could just turn around and go back.
Stop the bus, get off.
That was never a real option, was it? Sorry.
No, it's
you
not
going?
Prison, yeah, I'm just looking for...
Adam?
Yeah. I think me and him had a fight earlier today. I mean, we don't fight, we've known each other forever. We just sort of hang. Do you want to like go for a walk or something before we go into the club?
I need to find Adam. I don't think he's okay.
Yeah, Adam's in a bad place, I know. But I really don't think there's much we can do.
Actually, you know what? I'd really like to go for a walk.
Of course.
Tell me to relax. He'd tell me large groups of people ultimately produce bullshit and how it's just part of life. That the only way to work in a group is to let others take the credit, even if it's more than they deserve. I'd ask him why I thought like that, and he never answered me. Just smile and wink, like he knew better. Maybe sing a bit of Imagine at me. Arrogant prick. See the guys that came in from the balcony. They spot me and wave. Then they point to a girl and give me the thumbs up. And that's how I know I'm fucked.
Everyone's looking at me. Waiting for what I do. Booty lads, cheerleaders, slinger. The crowd, what can I do? Dance on the table, well, everyone's staring now admiring. I'm fucking super. I'm Adam Stone, and I'm going to tear this club apart!
I see a girl on a raised platform, and she's leaning against this safety rail. She's got a Barbie girl next to her, yeah. Always had a thing with girls with daddy issues. I grab her hand and I pull her toward the dance floor. I can't be asked to listen to what she's going on about, so I just push people out of the way to my room. Then some guy drops his drink, way up. Guy pushes me, I push him back. He pushes me back harder. I step back into Barbie, her drink goes down the top. I see her nips. Her girlfriend are wearing a bra. Then she dumps her drink back on me.
Revenge.
There's some angry guy in the checkered shirt, probably her boyfriend, steps after me and I'm like, what the fuck? Do you know who the fuck I am? What the fuck?
I'm Adam this. I step up onto the range platform, I throw my drink down, and I take off my shirt, and then I throw it down and I start singing at the top of my lungs.
It all falls apart.
And I fade into the crowd. Okay, so 40 minutes waiting in line. And then another 10 going through security. And then another 10 to get my ticket, which costs £10. And then another 10 I want a drink, but let's face it, I deserve one.
Absolutely frozen in spots. This is really not my scene. And then I see a drunk dickhead dancing the table with his shirt off. How can that man just be himself? And I'm petrified of just talking to someone. Marius will call it my issues. That's what equals all of my problems. Just because he's always been comfortable chilling without his shirt on. I mean, he was never exactly ripped. He just didn't give a fuck. Not like this guy. He's wants to be seen, heard, and known. Shit. It's Adam, that prick from the issue.
You dropped your shirt!
Kimmy! What are you doing here?
Okay, I'm here!
Why?
You need to sign the cover sheet. It's really important. It's due in the morning. Is he laughing?
He's pissing himself.
Poor girl.
No way! Are you disregarding? He's obsessed with all this bullshit over a cover sheet. He's just trying to get with me. You're stalking me. What, would I get drunk enough and get with you? But let me tell you a little secret, Kimmy. I would never get with someone like you.
She caught me!
She's falling apart.
Just like me.
Just like everybody else.
And suddenly I realise, all I feel is rage. I was fine until Adam started accusing me, making me question everything. It's his fault I'm in this stupid position where I have to prove myself. I feel Marissa's eyes on me, smiling, laughing, knowing better. It's his fault. Adam comes for me, pushing people out of the way. The guys in the balcony think I've bought it, or I haven't. I'm focused. I get to him, and as I put him on the shoulder, he looks so innocent. So surprised. Doesn't even recognize me.
Adam just freezes.
And then it's finally settling in. Everyone will be talking.
So he does the only thing he can do.
He smashes the poor guy in the face.
Yeah, I should step in.
Should we help him?
Hey, stop! I'm smashing it again!
I wanted to try it!
With that dick, with that drink from yesterday, with Adam Stone?
I wanted to try it with you.
Shit. Oh, listen, are you okay? Let me see that. Put your head. Does it hurt?
I'm fine. I feel kind of great, actually. So look, tomorrow. Last day of uni.
Yeah.
We should come out and celebrate. You know, just you and me.
Okay.
There's this band I think you really like. They're called the Cell Tap. It's Beatles spelled backwards. It's like a glam rock meets John Lennon sort of thing.
I can't believe the words glam rock and John Lennon just came out of your mouth. You can use the things, Colin.
Jesus. I know, but apparently they're a really good version of Imagine. Listen, I wanted to thank you for setting my arse out there.
I can't really save you. I
mean, you got addicted, yeah? You got it really good. It was kind of sexy, actually.
Good. It better be, since my nose is obviously broken now. But, look still. Thank you.
You can thank me tomorrow.
Adam, you're bleeding everywhere. Does it hurt?
Like how it does.
Here.
Why are you helping me? Kimmy? Kimmy, I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. If you came out here to make me feel bad, congratulations, I feel like shit. Kimmy, I'll say I'm sorry, okay? Say something.
Do you want to come back to mine? I can keep a face up for you, I hid it around the corner.
If I go back to hers, I will fuck her. Maybe I'll do it for the story, the adventure, the banter. Maybe it will be worth it. Alright, thanks.
But you have to sign the cover sheet.
Okay.
Promise?
I promise. Nothing good happens.
was never hard to imagine. But now he's here, and he's taking his shirt off. And it isn't like anything I thought it'd be like. But he looks nervous, sipping on the water I just gave him. Like he's walked into a foreign land. Like he's out of his kingdom. He tells me about what happened to him tonight. About how the bartender from the SU kissed him, and how it's his fault that everything's so fucked up. And I'm trying not to listen. But I can feel it affect me. I can feel myself sympathise, like all the other girls. And I hate that.
I'll be right back, I need the bathroom. This is it. Exactly what I wanted. The sex, the story. But something doesn't feel right. Okay, I'm gonna do the shit thing here and Kimmy's gonna freak. But this is gonna be one epic night. I sit my ass on the toilet. I try to get things going. I can't stop staring at my face. It's covered in bruises. I can't be a good sign when I just soak in the bad. My bad eye is leaking, it looks like I'm crying. So I just cover both sides. And I sit in the darkness for a bit. Suddenly, I don't need the shit anymore. So I just piss and flush. I go back out there and I see Kimmy lying there. Not a bad body, really. Could do with a little bit of timing on legs, bums and tums. But before I even touch her, before I even say, she says what I've known since day one, that she's never. And I'm like, fuck this! This is bullshit! I'm here on my own, responsible, and I don't want to be. Why can't someone else come and take care of this? Why should I have to shoulder it? But she just lies there, barely moving. I guess I don't really have a choice at all. I go near her face. I look in her eyes. She looks pissed and angry, and I'm starting to remember the way I've treated her and the things I've said tonight. And I'm trying to think of the words to make this a little less fucked up. I don't have any. So I just put my arm over her and let her sleep. Baking soda is the best thing to get vomit out of your clothes, according to Google. You just rub it in. And it dissolves everything like magic. The smell is another issue though.
Fuck, my head hurts.
It's alright.
It's just normal.
Look, have some water.
You stayed.
Yeah, the floor's surprisingly comfortable.
Alright then. What time is it?
10.
Fuck, oh, great work.
It's cool, it's my duty time too. And it's a little bit sticky. I'm starting to fall.
Thanks.
And it's going to be a bit shit because I had to do it on my phone. But I've done my part of the assignment. And I'm going to send it to Dr. Petrov. And I'll tell him all the work he's seen has actually only ever been yours.
What?
I'll send it to your email. Do you think you could just check it over before I send it in?
Adam, I appreciate the gesture, but we'll all get marked down. How about ahead of the work we already have?
Thank God. I was hoping you would say that. My work is shit. Okay, well, I'll hand it in. You send it.
Okay, you can do that.
So you really like Hello Kitty?
Shut up.
Hey, feel free to say no. But what about after I hand the work in? Me and you hang out. It's kind of a special day, handing the last assignment. The last day of uni.
I know.
Do you know what we should do? Rent a boat. I've always wanted to try it, but you need two people, you see. And I know it's silly, but I just really want to try it. Look, it's been a weird day. A weird week. A weird year. But on the last day of being students, this is all I want to do. Rent a boat. With you.
Okay, give me a footlong. Spice Italian.
Meatballs.
Herbs and cheeses.
Alright, let me write this down.
I'm sorry. And then 3, 6, okay, 9 months' time I'll be different. I want to tell her that I'll get a job and I'll be nice to people. I want to say that maybe this could go somewhere and that we won't turn out like our parents. I don't know if any of that's true, but I know that's what I want to tell people.
And sour cream, like in a little pot on the side,
okay,
you know?
Okay, I think I have everything. I'll be right back.